Yo, told y'all gonna do this one. I'm tell y'all right now, ain't nobody gonna be able to catch all these bars.
Yeah.
Nobody.
When I write, I'm like, who gonna catch my bars? When we the ones that eat clips. Niggas claiming they sick, but need a nursing home that help catch all these shit. I'm out your zone, nigga, man up. Better double up on this Gemini. Try to roam in, them numerals rules gonna follow up right in your eye. This Greek god mythology. Step out of line and get a boosie fade. Get boxed up, this Alpha Kappa Alpha when you try to invade. I'm Sam Beckett on a damn regular. Quantum leap gets manifested. When the stars align, the universe confines me to reconstruct all your past methods.
Yo. We all know moving is a hassle, and we hate to do it.
Hate it,
but we got some people who love it. If you need to move, and you want to move in style, you need to hit up Showtime Relocations, and they're going to come pack you up and move you in style.
You don't have to do anything.
You don't have to pack, you don't have to do nothing. They handle everything. They big fans of script work, man, so hit up my man Chris and let them know that, you know what I'm saying, hey, I'm trying to move in style.
And there's no job too big or too small.
Facts.
Do it all.
And how can they reach them?
They can just visit www.showtimerelocations.net and just put in a request for an estimate. Or you can call the number at 937-232-5943.
That's a bar.
That is a bar.
Let's go.
Yo.
Yo, what up?
What's good?
Hey, yo, shouts out to the citizens of Planet Breakdown. We are here. We back.
Yeah, we back. You know what I'm saying? We here. You know what I'm saying? With no regrets. And we're here, you know, doing no regrets.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
It's Eminem, no regrets.
Eminem, no regrets. Hey, real quick. 64% of our viewers are not subscribed. Like, how y'all are not subscribed and got the bell notification on? Because you're supposed to be subscribed and you're supposed to have that bell noti on so you can get notified when we drop new videos. The only way you're going to get it is you subscribe and you hit that bell icon. So please take this time to go and subscribe to us. It's 64% of the people watching our. You know what? People always say, oh man, this channel was so underrated. Oh man, y'all need to be at 1 million subs. But
probably
if the 64% of the people who watch this,
we would be,
we'll probably be at least 500,000.
Yeah,
if that 64 subscribe,
yeah,
that'll help us out, y'all. You know, I know a lot of times y'all don't have money to donate, y'all don't have money to do the super chats or anything like that. But you know, another way of helping us out is just subscribing to the channel. So please,
yeah,
do us that favor, please. Now, we're about to be into this no regrets bag. And guess what? I guarantee it. If you was to subscribe to our channel, you will have no regrets.
Featuring, that's what I was looking for. No regrets featuring Don Toliver.
Okay.
All right. I knew something was on. Yeah.
That shit stupid, dog.
What am I just listening to?
I got this energy in me right now, dog. I just want to hit something.
Go get Norm. Norm got to hit us.
Norm gotta hear this, dog.
Norm gotta hear this shit, boy. This shit hard, boy.
Why got,
go think, get Norm.
Where I done put Norm at, dog?
He behind the bar.
He behind the bar.
You know love. You know Norm loves some bars. All right, let's go.
We got Norm in the building. Norm, say what's up.
No, Norm love the bars.
Norm love the bars. Norm, hey, Norm, cheers. Norm sat at the end of the bar. But Norm is just the normal guy. We extraordinary. He's normal.
Like that, you know. If I got a chance to do it all over again, I wouldn't change shit.
I love this, yeah. And I love the vibe of it.
Yeah.
Yo, it's your boy Combo, and it's your boy Knockout dropping science on you like a college dropout. Yo, 911 shouting, 911 shouting, no time out.
No.
I got store emergency. I'm sorry, old boy, right? Script right, say God, get me in that thing, boy. I get in that nigga cooking, I change a few things. No, you feel me? You feel me, dog?
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say no. But yo, you need to handle that after our session.
And bump all that. Y'all folk whack anyway, so don't nobody wanna ride around bumping no chemistry.
Oh, so we whack now because we don't wanna dumb it down to your level to make a hit. Man, that hook is so...
It's beautiful.
It's beautiful, man.
It's so beautiful.
They missed the Omi. He just come in. And everybody missed the old now. I don't even know what the rest of what he about to say, but I just know that part is real.
That's real.
Well, like, I personally like the new M2. You know what I'm saying?
Because it's a mixture of all of them.
Yeah, yeah.
Like I'm so lost. Yeah, they miss the old me. I think they want me to OD on Cody. They want my life in turmoil like an O3. They want front row seats. I'll give them nosebleeds. They want me imploding, exploding, self-loading, eroding.
They want front row seats. I'll give them nosebleeds. You know
they
what
want
saying?
My life in turmoil like an O3. O3, everybody know that's when he was really going through it. You know what I'm saying? After, I can't remember what album he dropped in 02, but shit, like, he was going through it. That's when he had got on, like, all the pills and shit, the Valiums and the Vicodins, and he was going through it around that time. So but the music he was dropping at that time was a reflection of what he was going through.
Yeah.
And that's what people want to hear because they going through it and they want to relate.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They want him to be going through turmoil. They want the OM because the OM is what everybody relates to. And he's just keeping it real.
You gotta go a certain place to get there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Because so many people in this world go through so many things, and we just want to find somebody that relate, and there's somebody we can see that made it out. Like, if I'm having an anxiety attack, or if I'm dealing with something with, you know what I'm saying, mental health, or, you know what I'm saying, I'm not going to want to talk to a person who ain't never experienced it.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk to a person who's experienced it and say, yo, I've dealt with that before, and I'm good. This is what I did to make it out, and this is how I cope. That's who you want to feel. It's like a sense of comfort, a level of comfort that you get with him and his music, because he done been where we all done been. And people want the old M. They don't want the woke M.
And I like the entendre he did with they want front row seats. I give them nosebleeds. I was like, you know what I'm saying? They want front row seats, you know, shows. You know what I'm saying? He give them nosebleeds because he pack it out. Also, like, they want to be up close. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Personal, but I gotta push them away. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You can't be up close personally. I gotta push you to the nosebleeds,
man.
Cause you can't get that close to me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
He's like, that's how I maintain.
Yep.
In turmoil like an O3. They want front row seats. I give them nosebleeds. They want me imploding, exploding, self-loading, eroding. I'm screaming at them with no regrets and I'm hulking. I'm ripping out of my clothing. I had to go see the doc like Kumogi. Never took much to convince Drain.
I had to go see a doc like, what did he say, Kenobi?
Give them those bleeds. They want me imploding, exploding, self-loathing, eroding. I'm screaming at them with no regrets and I'm hoping. I'm ripping out of my clothing. I had to go see the doc like Kumodi. Never took much to...
had to see Dr. Kumodi. Kumodi.
Kumodi
a doctor now? A rev or something?
I don't know.
Mm. But Kumodi, you know what I'm saying? It's, him and LL Cool J had some great battles back in the day.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
He's
his famous his joint was How You Like Me Now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Real old school dope MC.
Mm-hmm. One of the dopest.
Yeah, one of the dopest.
And I'm hoping I'm ripping out of my clothing.
Kumodi was the first, I ain't gonna say he was the first, but he had that swag. Like, he just had this certain level of confidence. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. He was
like
a trendsetter.
He was definitely a trendsetter,
everybody
dog.
Wanted
he had
to walk
rings
around in the black, you know what I'm saying, with the shade. Everybody wanted the Kumodi shades.
Dog, for real. Kumodi is definitely an icon.
How you like me now? Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah. Exploding, self-loading, eroding. I'm screaming at him with no regrets and I'm hoping. I'm ripping out of my clothing. I had to go see the doc like Kumodi. Never took much to convince Dre. Never been swayed by color or skin shapes. Since day one, hell razor with twin blades. I'm a sensei, giving up, no comprende. Tin brain, probably.
These flips be crazy.
Floating, exploding, self-loading, eroding. I'm screaming at him with no regrets and I'm hoping. I'm ripping out of my clothing. I had to go see the doc like Kumodi. Never took much to convince Dre. Never been swayed by color or skin shapes. Since day one, hell razor with twin blades. I'm a sensei, giving up, no comprende. Tin brain, probably.
Hell razor with twin blades. Why you flipping it in there?
Him just, dog. He's just such a brilliant wordsmith.
Yeah.
It blows my mind every time to just hear how he put words together,
his
dog.
His patterns are unreal.
That shit is unbelievable, dog.
Skin shades since day one, hell razor with twin blades. I'm a sensei, giving up, no comprende. Tin brain, probably fucked in the membrane. Slim shade, mind's in the guard of an insane pin game. Like I just struck in the tin frame.
Pin game, like I just struck in the tin frame.
Like I just struck in the tin frame.
Dog. He giving them a 30.
He giving them,
Cause you know what I'm saying, the 10th frame, you get a strike.
Right. You get two more shots.
You get two more shots and you get a strike. Right, you get a chance at three strikes.
Yeah, yeah.
He said he dropping 30 on y'all niggas. I
what are you talking about? Talking about? That was home.
Come on, man.
What the fuck you want gonna catch in him? I'm stupid. Don't feel bad. No one know what he gets into when he sits here. It's just what we do.
About to get a turkey on y'all fools.
That was crazy.
Anybody get a turkey on y'all fools.
Sensei minds in the corner of an insane pin game like I just struck in the 10th frame.
Pin game like I just struck in the 10th. The pin game with bowling pins. Come on, dawg.
Fucked in the membrane, slim shade, mind's in the guard of an insane pin game. Like I just struck in the 10th frame.
Screaming out, no regrets.
I live on the edge, I sit on the ledge. To shit on your heads, I've been on the bench. Forgiven for...
I live on the edge, I sit on the ledge to shit on your head. That's crazy, because you think about it, he walk a fine line in his bars.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? He's like really walking on edge with the shit he's saying.
Yeah.
He's still shitting on y'all heads when he say it.
Yup.
Talking about Norm.
Talking about we.
Come on.
Stop playing.
Oh. Nigga had his hand on my butt.
Oh hell no.
Oh,
Norm.
Nigga had his hand on my butt.
What?
Nigga had his boy, man. You know what?
Norm violate.
I'ma let him slide. Cause I don't.
Cause he did get them things.
Yeah.
Don't feel down. Don't be sad.
Look, I don't wanna. Gonna get caught up in no Kevin Hart scandal. It's okay, Norman. It was an accident.
I've been on the bench, forgive and forget. The only thing I've ever lived is regret. I've been on revenge, you let me forget. I cried on my grave, you better be ready and set. My enemies, they put an enemy, yeah. Screaming
my enemies ain't put an end to me yet.
That was hard. That was nice.
Yeah, my enemies ain't put an end to me
yet. You know what I'm saying? Battle tested. Mm-hmm. Ain't I'm still here kicking, dropping and drop, getting the top spot every time I drop. No promotion.
No promotion. Weapons ready and set, my enemies, they put a king in me, yeah. Screaming out, you've been through the hardest fight. He got the largest, I made you a star.
Can't tell exactly where it stems from, but it's happening again. Y'all used to be in my corner, now you just back me in one. Innocent bystanders.
Y'all used to be in my corner, but now you just back me in one.
Ooh, that was hard right there.
That was
boy. Hard.
Ah! You know how it must feel to have people that ride with you in your corner, but now they trying to back you in one?
As in, and they try to press you into that, you know what I'm saying? They want you one way and one way only.
That's it.
And if you ain't that way with them, you know what I'm saying? They don't want nothing to do with you.
That's it.
Until they force you back into that way.
Facts.
That was so cold right there.
Facts.
Hit home right there.
Yeah, hit home.
Y'all used to be in my corner, now you just back me in one. Innocent bystanders, I'm bound to hit some. For some adversaries, I carry big guns. So some targets will get the kill shot. Some I just barely nicked them. I can make a mistake and he dropped in it.
Oh! That was a Nick Cannon diss. That was a Nick diss. That was a Nick diss. He said, some of my targets get the kill shots, but some I just barely nicked them. Some I just barely nicked them.
So you can get Machine Gun Kelly'd.
Yeah, or you can get nicked.
And you can get nicked at night.
You can get nicked at night. You can get MGK'd or you can get nicked at night.
Oh, that was hard. Some I just barely nicked them. So what he's saying is,
he uses
beat. That was a nick what I sent down.
Yeah.
Don't make me jump out here.
No, go back. Don't make him use
Don't
the big
make
guns.
Me jump out here.
Because he was just talking about using the big guns and the target. You know what I'm saying? Let's see what he's talking about.
Now you just back me in one. Innocent bystanders, I'm bound to hit some. For some adversaries, I carry big guns. For some targets, you get the kill shot.
Yeah, for some adversaries, I carry big guns. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, some targets, they get the, you know what I'm saying?
And you know.
Yeah.
He wasn't against Machine Gun Kelly. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Got the big gun.
Kill shot was a big blast.
Yeah, it was a big blast.
He used his big guns.
Big
on
blast,
MGK.
Big blast.
Yeah.
Standards, I'm bound to hit some. For some adversaries, I carry big guns. For some targets, you get the kill shot. So much is barely nicked them.
Also, he said, some innocent bystanders gonna get hit. And I feel like Nick Cannon, he was an innocent bystander. Because he was going at Mariah.
Mm.
But Nick was her husband at the time, so he was an innocent bystander. He didn't want to have nothing to do with it, but
not only, and look, and also not only got doggone is the black squad guy goddamn go get hit up, the whole wild and out who ain't even had nothing to do with go get hit
innocent
up.
Innocent bystanders.
We got the whole cast hit up. Don't even know it.
Hey, it's fucked up that boy Nick Cannon got in a beef with his favorite rapper over who he married. Like, he liked M. He said he had M as one of the GOATs.
Yeah.
But now you in a beef with the GOAT, and it's because of who you married. That sucks.
And not married to now.
Right, and not married to now.
Now you just back me in one. Innocent bystanders, I'm bound to hit some. For some adversaries, I carry big guns. For some targets, you get the kill shot. Some I just barely nicked them. I can make a mistake and erupt and end up taking a dump or saying some dumb shit, thinking I run shit. Misplacing my anger enough to give Earl and Tyler the creator the brunt. Should have never made a response to the disdain for the fake.
You said give Earl and Tyler the creator the what?
Blunt. Give him that smoke.
Yeah, that Earl's sweatshirt.
Mm-hmm.
Because he gave them a shout out on his last on Kamikaze.
Yeah, he gave him a shot. All right,
yeah.
Talk shit on him.
Yeah.
I can make a mistake and erupt and end up taking a dump or saying some dumb.
I can make a mistake.
Yeah, so I'ma just hit. Y'all used to be in my corner. Now you just back me in one. Innocent bystanders, I'm bound to hit some. For some adversaries, I carry big guns. So some target to get the kill shot. So I'ma just barely nicked them. I can make a mistake and erupt and end up taking a dump or saying some dumb shit. Thinking I run shit. Misplacing my anger enough to give Earl and Tyler the creator the brunt. Should've never made a response to the disdain for the fake ones. Them traitorous punks. Cause snakes are just cunts. They can get fucked with 800 motherfucking vibrators at once. If for any of them.
He said he never should have responded.
Y'all can get fucked with 800 vibrators at once.
800.
800.
800 vibrators 800. At once.
That's what he think about them.
That's crazy.
He can get fucked with 800 vibrators at once. Well, he's tearing their ass up.
He's tearing their ass up, literally. Literally, dog.
He turned his ass up.
Literally, 800. Yo, he turned, he fucking them up, boy.
Oh.
That's crazy.
Punks, cause snakes are just cunts, they can get fucked with 800 motherfucking vibrators at once. If for any of those who may have come close to about dying, they can't listen to a rose without crying. For those who feel low, like you're about spiraling, but this is only for those that I'm inspiring. Weapon never unholstered without firing. My will, I'm imposing, foes are gonna feel.
I never upholstered without firing.
Woo! Never unholstered without firing.
Ooh!
Weapon.
Once I pull, it's over.
Facts. And then if you think about it, with the pen, he never unholsters his pen without writing some fire.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He never, because his pen is his weapon. His pen is his weapon. He never write without fire, bro.
I would just love to be in the goddamn room while Eminem in the zone writing some shit like this.
I got a feeling M don't write around nobody. He probably isolate himself and straight just genius.
I would love to see that writing process.
I bet him and 3 Stacks, they don't write around nobody.
Yeah.
They just, I just can't see it.
Eminem's so dope, dog.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's only for those that I'm inspired. Never made a response to the disdain for the fake ones. And traitorous punks, cause snakes are just cunts. They can get fucked with 800 motherfucking vibrators at once. And for any of those who may have come close to about dying, they can't listen to a rose without crying. For those who feel low, like you're about spiraling, but this is only for those that I'm inspiring. Weapon never unholstered without firing. My will, I'm imposing. Foes are gonna feel like they're in the throes of a mountain lion. They talk about my daughters hoping to fly.
They can't listen to a rose without crying. The song he did, A Rose.
Yeah.
That shit was emotional, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, that shit was emotional.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He can't.
Like, just for, like, all of y'all, you know what I'm saying? Like,
Like, don't even respond to the haters. Let me talk to the people who my music really touch. Mm-hmm. The people who listen to a rose and get emotional and cry and feel for me. That's who I should be responding to.
And this whole spill after that is like, you know what I'm saying? Now that I got your attention, let me talk some real shit to you.
Yup.
My will, I'm imposing. Foes are gonna feel like they're in the that I'm inspiring. Can't listen to a rose with vibrators at once. And for any of those who may have come close to about dying, they can't listen to a rose without crying. For those who feel low, like you're about spiraling, but this is only for those that I'm inspiring. Weapon never unholstered without firing. My will, I'm imposing. Foes are gonna feel like they're in the throes of a mountain lion. They talk about my daughter's hope.
Foes are gonna feel like they're in the throes of a mountain lion. Ugh. Yeah. Those with poles will feel like they're going to throw them a mile wide. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I love my fans and I love people who ride with me, but if you're on the other side, then we got a problem.
We got a problem. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We got a problem.
My will, I'm imposing. Foes are gonna feel like they're in the throes of a mountain lion. They talk about my daughters hoping to fly off of the handle. Cause my first thought is to trample and rent 1,000 bars. But sometimes it's like dropping an anvil on a house of cards. A Godzilla squashing a crouton with combat boots on. A dropping a goddamn nuke bomb on top of an anvil. Can't do it.
Talk about his daughter.
People try to use his daughter.
You know what I'm saying? Like, first I want to grab pen key by the thousand word, but then I feel like I got them Godzilla stomping you, dropping bombs on them. You know what I'm saying?
Don't talk about my fucking daughters.
Yeah. You don't know which way it's going to go.
And you know, Haley's name stay coming up in their mouth.
Stay. I don't know why people still do that.
My daughter's hoping to fly off of the handle. Cause my first thought is to trample and rent 1,000 bars. But sometimes it's like dropping an anvil on a house of cards. A Godzilla squashing a crouton with combat boots on. A dropping a gun.
Godzilla squashing a crouton with combat boots on.
That's how bad he'll crush your ass. Like Godzilla with combat boots on. Stepping on a crouton.
Good lord.
Dropping an anvil on a house of cards, a Godzilla squashing a crouton with combat boots on, a dropping a goddamn nuke bomb on top of an anthill.
Dropping a goddamn nuke bomb on the top of an anthill.
Come on, dog.
A nuke bomb on top of an anthill.
That's how big he is. Like, it ain't even no comparison what he could do to you and what we can do to your career.
Combat boots on, a dropping a goddamn nuke bomb on top of an anthill.
And he don't regret killing anybody he done killed.
No regrets.
No regrets. Boy, that shit is cold.
Next time you do this,
that shit is cold.
Be doing this.
Boy, that shit cold. Playlist.
Definitely on the playlist.
Automatically.
Go to our Spotify playlist.
That might get moved to the first song on the playlist.
That shit is nice. Go to our Spotify playlist, guys, and this, you know, Timeless Hip Hop. Hit play. You want to go to the gym, you want to drive to work, wherever, I'm home from work, go to our Spotify playlist and listen to the songs.
It was cold.
That shit was cold, dog. We might have to do a behind the bar on this. We might have to do a behind the bar on this,
We'll let them vote.
All right, let them vote. Peace, love, and respect, man. Y'all make sure y'all get somebody a hug today. And don't be walking around with no regrets. No.
Script work. When you stop it.
That shit still recording. I was just playing, y'all.
And I don't care, I'm just sipping on this yak. They can try to call me in, but I'ma be where I'm at. And in tomorrow, I got a bottle and some edibles. I hope I hit the lotto, I'm just fading away. I'm fading to stay. I ain't going in tomorrow, I got a bottle and some edibles. I hope I hit the lotto, I'm just fading away.
Yo, we all know moving is a hassle, and we hate to do it.
Hate it.
But we got some people who love it. If you need to move and you want to move in style, you need to hit up Showtime Relocations, and they can come pack you up and move you in style.
You don't have to do anything.
You don't have to pack, you don't have to do nothing. They handle everything. They big fans of script work, man, so hit up my man Chris and let them know that, you know what I'm saying, hey, I'm trying to move in style.
And there's no job too big or too small.
Facts.
Do it all.
And how can they reach them?
They can just visit www.showtimerelocations.net and just put in a request for an estimate. Or you can call the number at 937-232-5943.
That's a bar!
That is a bar!
Let's go!